Well, let's see. If while we're waiting, because that's already in the works,
okay,
but on the other side is this. Those people, those contestants have left your party. They've gone on to other parties. One of them said, I've gone on to Accord. They've left your party, and that's one. The other one left to SDP or one of those other parties. At the end of the day, how would that affect your fortunes at the elections if they move, and as they move, they are moving with their supporters?
No, you see, the point is that we've had people coming to our party as well. Don't forget that we're in the season of new brides. We have so many political brides going around the street now. People are trying to look for relevance, you understand? People are trying to change parties, and they're trying to look for future favors. We have a former PDP chairman just joined our party now, Gemade, from Benue State. He's a sitting senator. Do you understand me? It does not mean he's coming with millions of people to our party, but he's a credible, he's a more acceptable, he's a more national figure coming to our party. People who want to leave the party, I won't tell them to leave the party. But the point is that, will they get what they want in that party? We could build this party together. There's no point screaming more than leaving the party over that because of their particular grievances.
The question will be whether there are chances. If they believe that there are some people who are already sitting there and are trying to dictate the base or dictate what will obtain without giving the room for fair play, perhaps they will begin to say, maybe this is not the place for us.
Well, we don't dictate in APC. We have seen from the top. We are very clear.
Well, this is the first time you're conducting. This is the first time that, you know, well, this is the first time that the APC is coming together as a political party. But if you're to go by the history of the parties that came together to make the APC, transparent primaries has not always been their thing. It's always been a consensus arrangement in which we cannot say, oh, one political party or one area or one particular person was not in charge. It was really a consensus.
Okay, well, probably you have to be more clear about your question. I'm not very clear about your question. APC is probably a year and a half old now.
Mm-hmm.
Understand me? We have, for the first time, we've gone to the polls for internal democracy and we've excelled. We have CEL, we have AMPP,
you're rating
CPC,
that based on
ACN.
Just a moment. We're rating that based on what has happened at the national level. Is that what we're basing on?
Even at the state level as
because
well.
We've also seen some of the divisions in some of the states as a result of what has happened there. Yes, you have new brides coming into your party, and in that case, you give some of them, you know, the leeway to emerge.
The leeway.
Yes, let's take a look at just a moment. Let's take a look at Imo State, where the presidential candidate or an aspirant was coming, you know, to test his popularity at the national level.
Mm-hmm.
By the time that process was over, of course, he had an automatic ticket waiting for him in Imo State. Wasn't that the case?
Was that a leeway or a process in place? Have you forgotten?
Did he participate in the process?
No, of course he did. Of course he did. You understand me?
How did he participate?
Excuse me, right? If we have a process, right, and I want to take my chances in the center, and I come back, I haven't lost in the center,
uh-huh.
And my people still believe I'm the best man for the job, and they gave it to me. What is wrong with that?
Oh, wait.
Saraki did this about a few years ago here. So was Senator Jimmy Wobodo. In this same country, this same republic, this same democracy.
Well, we all know that within politicians.
That's right.
Amongst politicians, so they always. Just a moment, sir. You know that amongst politicians, they always have their arrangements. We know that everything is about risk, political risk. I try it here. If it doesn't work, make sure that I still have this one. At least there's some form of compensation. Isn't that sometimes the arrangement?
Well, you see, the point is that politics is a game where you have your permanent interest in place.
Mm-hmm.
You understand me? So if you're talking about coming out for an election, right, and you try your luck probably another year or another type or something else different entirely, it's allowed to do that. You're allowed to do that in politics. It's not a game because you lose now, you are dead forever. No, there's always be a time to come back and try again. That's the whole idea.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you see people coming out and trying to test their popularity within the people in the democratic concept.
But looking at the parties, let's take a look at Ogun State,
yeah,
where there was also a fallout of some sort. We saw the creation, or is it the revival of the SDP?
What do you
think that this affects your party's chances come 2015?
You see, I will not tell you about party chances. I will tell you, I mean, politically, right, anybody leaving your party is not good for you, for the party image. But the point is, what people make up their mind on what they want to do, right, regarding a particular situation, then trying to get across to them is almost a lost cause. That is the truth. Mm-hmm. Ogun State, we will still do better in Ogun State than we did the last election.
Mm-hmm.
I'm very sure about that. But the deputy governor leaving the party, mm-hmm. right, after just complaining, it was a planned thing. There was no room for reconciliation and left up straight to SDP.
Mm-hmm.
That is the truth.
In conclusion, though, do you think, how do you rate your candidate's chances at the 2015 election?
Which of our candidates?
At the national level.
Very, very good. Very, very good. A very credible candidate, a well acceptable candidate. It was what he did 4 years ago in a short time with his new party then. So we believe come next year we have a new president and commander chief of this.
How critical is your the primaries for your picking the vice presidential slot, you know, to the success of
the primaries for picking that.
Mm-hmm.
The party working on that, and we should come back and come out to you guys with a very, very acceptable candidate.
How soon would that be?
Well, probably today, because I think INEC should be submitted on the 18th of December in another 2 days. But I will tell you something. Just keep your finger crossed.
Okay.
I will come back to you with something that you all will accept as a good competitor for Nigeria's future.
All right. Thank you very much, Tunde Bank Anthony, for coming on the program. Thank
You're
you.
You're welcome. Thank you so much.
Tunde Bank Anthony is a member of the All Progressives Congress. Sunrise Steady will be back shortly. Don't go away. Seen some of your comments, quite a number of other ones are still pouring, especially on the internal democracy. But we want to say thank you so much for being such a wonderful company and allowing us to be a part of your morning. So we'll come your way tomorrow. I'm Neo Taigbe.
Well, thank you for watching. I'm Maope Ogun.
Have a good day.